at the root or at the heart of a lot of these neurological disorders is a metabolic dysfunction and how, first of all, when we talk about nutritional ketosis, to me, it's such a broad way of describing.
Very broad, yeah.
You know, like, what is nutritional ketosis? Like, and how do you achieve it?
Mm-hmm. So nutritional ketosis could be, it's defined, it kind of has the same definition in my mind. It's achieving and sustaining a level of blood ketones. And I think when people say they've done the ketogenic diet, they did that, you know, it didn't work for them or it did work for them, I would ask the question, well, did you measure blood ketones? Did you confirm, in fact, that you were able to achieve a state of ketosis defined as an elevation of blood ketones above 0.5 millimolar at the very least? Ideally, you want to stay between 1 and 3 millimolar of ketones. And when you've achieved that state,
I'm
talking about blood ketones, yeah, which is kind of the gold standard. And this can be measured. There's a number of different devices out there that measure blood ketones. And when the state of nutritional ketosis is achieved, you're also not only that biomarker is kind of there and we have technologies to measure it, but it would also be important to measure your blood glucose and maybe insulin levels too. So when the suppression of the hormone insulin drives hepatic ketogenesis. It drives the body's ability to make ketones. And that has therapeutic implications for type 2 diabetes, obviously. So my definition of nutritional ketosis would be an elevation of blood ketones, and the difficulty in prescribing that or telling someone to do it is that the way to implement that is kind of similar with everyone, but everyone responds differently depending on where you're coming from. So if you have an obese subject that's type 2 diabetic, it's going to be different than an athlete or different. And women, there's some differences between women and men, I think. So defining nutritional ketosis is relatively easy with an elevation of blood ketones, but implementing it and being able to, for the individual to commit to it and have that ability to control their diet, which is very linked to lifestyle, has been sort of a difficult thing to do. And that's where ketone supplementation kind of comes in and can allow someone to rapidly achieve nutritional ketosis and sustain it and perhaps get many of the therapeutic benefits that we're just finding out now. We know that ketones are more than just the metabolite. They're more than just an energy metabolite that the brain can use, but they are metabolites, especially beta-hydroxybutyrate, are very powerful signaling molecules.
Right.
And we're just beginning to understand sort of the therapeutic effects of these metabolites as signaling molecules. And that's a big thrust of our lab right now.